Good afternoon, Your Excellencies, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. I consider it's a great honor and a privilege to address this gathering. And I want to thank the Indian Foundation for inviting me as one of the guest speakers. I'm very happy to see a lot of contemporaries where I have met, and my commandant of Wellington Staff College is also here, General Manik. And with India and Sri Lanka, we have a lot of interactions. We have met frequently and visited. I think myself, I have visited many times. I have done, people call me as a half Indian because I have done a lot of training there. So gentlemen, I was attending from last evening. Everybody talking on the same matter. So I'm also covering little aspects. I selected to the topic, the way forward in building peace through partnership in the Indian Ocean region based on common security architecture. Ladies and gentlemen, it is believed that maritime trade in the Indian Ocean region involving this island nation was flourishing even 5,000 years ago. Anyone studying the maritime history of Sri Lanka and the Asian region will come across abundance of evidence to ascertain beyond any reasonable doubt that the Indian Ocean region, especially Sri Lanka, was at the center of vibrant sea route where seafarers who braved the uncertainties of ocean to sail far east to the west to engage in lucrative trade of spices and precious stones among many other commodities. Ladies and gentlemen, the demand, attraction and the resultant gain of the trade was such that European maritime powers wanted to have a permanent influence in the Indian Ocean. From around 15th century, European colonial powers started expanding and compete with each other to have the region under their sphere of influence. The colonization of the region by the European powers firmly established this influence. The European domination continued for about 5 centuries. This domination continued until the end of World War II. Thereafter, during the Cold War era, the power play in the Indian Ocean region changed into different dynamics. This has been widely discussed during many forums similar to this, and I will limit this to my introduction. Ladies and gentlemen, however, after a full cycle of dynamic changes in the political order, in an established fact that the center of gravity of world economic growth has shifted towards the Asian region. Consequent to these developments, Indian Ocean region has gained serious attention of all global powers due to its connectivity to the Atlantic and the Pacific, driving the economic growth into region and the world. In this developing maritime-centric geopolitical and economic context, we in Sri Lanka, being in the most strategic location in the Indian Ocean, has attracted unprecedented focus as a potential maritime hub and a center of growth. At the same time, the importance of safeguarding the sea line of communication that connects the East and the West and vice versa in achieving stability and the peace in the region therefore has become a key strategic concern. This is especially due to the significance of the Indian Ocean acting as a conduit of the energy flow, the Asia-Pacific economic growth centers. The fact that this conference is held in Sri Lanka in any way, recognizing of that reality, as we all know, the last year's conference was held in Singapore, a country that we in Sri Lanka aspired to emulate since early 80s. It is the country that benefited from strategically important maritime location and by adapting prudent strategies. Although the Singapore model is something that Sri Lanka has been discussing in the last few decades, we have not been able to achieve success due to long-drawn conflict that pushed our country backward and also partly due to lack of progressive policy framework. So as a maritime nation, the time has come to recognize how Sri Lanka should contribute to the overall Indian Ocean maritime security, peace and stability, and in the return, grab the opportunities and reap the benefits that are right in front of our doorsteps. Ladies and gentlemen, However, all these factors depend on how Indian Ocean region maritime order is shaped in order to sustain peace and stability through a consciousness approach of all stakeholders in coming years. Therefore, Sri Lanka is now passing through a period of relying our maritime policies to suit the emerging maritime order of the Indian Ocean. It is apparent to anyone that many conferences, forums and discussions similar to this conference being held regularly, and that the main focus in all such endeavors is to share views on how best the Indian Ocean security architecture should be formed to ensure that interests of all stakeholders are preserved while efficiently managing the Indian Ocean region for common prosperity, peace and stability. Primarily, for unhindered oceanic trade, unfettered access in the maritime domain is mandatory. It is maritime security which will underpin such access by allowing free movements of navigation, trade and lawful exploitation of resources. The enormity of the ocean space that surrounds us makes it mandatory that all countries who share common objectives and values in securing the seas confront the challenges in the collaborative manner. It is prudent to keep in mind that the Global Maritime Community is confronting an increasingly challenging security environment. Terrorism, all forms of smuggling, natural disasters, the increasing importance of space and cyber needs, compatible capacity and capability. Hence, strategic partnership and collaboration need to be pursued and encouraged by all states. Ladies and gentlemen, the challenges we face could be categorized four broad areas. There are traditional challenges between state, non-traditional challenges by non-state actors, natural disasters and serious environmental concerns. The answer to these challenges lie with bilateral and multilateral framework of cooperation, capacity building and interoperability, and agreements that commitment to adhere to a rule-based maritime order. In this context, the proposals that have been proposed through this forum itself towards building a common security architecture agreed by all stakeholders become very important. Such consensus will lead to networking of navies in the collaborative approach towards peace and stability. More importantly, it will bring trust and confidence that shrink space for disagreement and conflict and mitigate mistrust. I would like to mention that we have seen improved cooperation among the nations in the region and also supported by powerful maritime nations which are outside the region, but consider the region is vital for their national security interests. Even with such cooperation, many security challenges remain and many traditional and non-traditional challenges are evolving in the future. As shaping patterns changes and new transit hubs emerging, refocusing of effort will become necessary. Ladies and gentlemen, therefore, much cooperative efforts need to be formulated. Improving the accessibility for maritime domain awareness is a key factor in this proposed collaboration efforts. Therefore, it is my view that assistance by advanced states in the region to smaller navies to increase this capacity must be persistent. In conclusion, I would like to note in a very strategic context, we all have to be mindful that understand evolving security partnerships that are centric to the Indian Ocean region. In this context, the outcome of the recent discussion between the leaders of India and US on maritime cooperation is of great importance. Both countries have a large presence and foothold in the Indian Ocean region, and the commitment shown for increased cooperation and partnership and for the rule-based maritime order is encouraging, and hope that such cooperation would bring greater stability to the region. Ladies and gentlemen, in this background, a common maritime security architecture, I would argue, has never been more opportunity for necessary. It should allow cooperation and partnership, promote rule-based maritime activity, allow bilateral and multilateral cooperation, create space for assistance of needy nations to be supported by advanced nations for capacity building, in the transparent approach, enhance maritime domain awareness, and most importantly, should have voluntary consensus on refraining of planning or carrying out action that hinders the security balance of the Indian Ocean region. I believe best course is that the all should strive to steer for a secure, stable and peaceful Indian Ocean region. Thank you.